Hey guys, this is Raghav, and I'm going to show you something fun today. I'm going to show you why Minikube runs containers inside containers. I started using Minikube about 2 years ago because I wanted to play around with local Kubernetes clusters, and it seemed to be the easiest way to do it. A few weeks ago, I was working on a different video of mine, how to deploy a first application to Kubernetes. And for that, I was actually digging deeper into the internals of Minikube. And one thing I started immediately wondering was, how is Minikube running an entire Kubernetes cluster on my laptop? You've got the API server, etcd, controller manager, scheduler, kubelets, and God knows what. By default, Minikube runs Kubernetes cluster on your laptop using Docker. But when I run Docker PS on my laptop after running a Minikube cluster, all I see is a bunch of containers using the KIC base image. So in this video, I'm going to show you some very fancy engineering that the smart people developing Minikube applied. And you're going to learn why Minikube runs containers inside containers. So here we go. Minikube uses a very interesting trick to run all the Kubernetes cluster processes locally. So first of all, what happens when I run a new Kubernetes cluster on my local using Minikube? I'm going to run a cluster with 3 nodes and call it prod. Now, when I run a cluster, firstly, Minikube pulls a base image onto my local to run the cluster, right? And this new image is called KIC base. This one right here. Now, this image comes packed with all the applications and data that are needed to run a full Kubernetes cluster, all the processes as part of the Kubernetes cluster. Okay, so yeah, we have a running cluster. So once the cluster has started, I see 3 new containers running on my machine. All of these are from the KIC base image only. What's happening here is that for each node that exists in my Minikube cluster, Minikube creates a corresponding Docker container on my local. So one container runs one node. And you might notice that the container name is essentially the node name. Now, one of these nodes is treated as the control plane of the cluster, right here. And the rest of them are just worker nodes which will actually run my workloads. And so you can see that Minikube usually doesn't number the first node. It just says prod, for example. And that's usually the control plane node. And the others, which have M02, M03, these are the worker nodes. So how about we go inside the prod02 container now? By inside, what I mean is let's gain shell access inside this container just to examine things around, right? And going inside this container means essentially we are going inside the prod02 worker node. Prod02. Okay, so I have shell inside this container. Let's just clear out. Now here's the fun part. KIC base image has all the stuff that Kubernetes cluster needs to run, but it also has Docker installed on it. And as you can see, there are a bunch of containers running inside my node container. So these are like containers running inside my Kubernetes worker node. And notice that all the Kubernetes processes that a worker node requires to run, they are all running here as containers inside the node. Okay. And if I go inside the prod container, which is the control plane node, and I run Docker PS here, I see a lot more containers than the worker node. And this is because it is running all the control plane processes in addition to all the worker node processes. Let's just try to, I want to make it slightly simpler on the eyes. Yeah, so I can see the API server, scheduler, controller manager, kindnetd, etcd, everything is right here. So as soon as you're running a Minikube cluster on your local machine, you're actually running a bunch of KIC base image based containers. And each of those containers in turn is running more containers inside it to actually power the Kubernetes node. Based on whether its role is control plane node or the worker node, it runs certain containers. And this is why we say that Minikube actually runs containers inside containers. So like, maybe we can call it a containerception. This is a very smart way of running complex software like Kubernetes on your local machine by doing containers inside containers. But of course, don't do this in production. It is not at all efficient to run container inside container in a production environment. You're just wasting resources and decreasing the performance of your application. But of course, for development environments, this kind of a trick could actually be very helpful. And Minikube actually proves that you can do it and quite efficiently. I hope you had fun learning this little trick. If you enjoyed this video, go share it with your friends and let them know that containerception is a real word and that they should take it very seriously. See you next time.